Panacea, and welcome to the episode of Space Engineers. In this one, we're taking a look at the handhold COG handle emergency locker by Chipsticks 213, and also the Linux, like something. There's some blocks by those two. Why do some people have some names that I can't pronounce? Oh well, doesn't matter. Because these blocks are just getting handy. Granted, it's primarily hydrogen tanks, but they are absolutely massive compared to others. Especially azimuth ones. I did check if these could be put on small ships. Oh well. So anyway, how about we start taking a look at these hydrogen tanks? Maybe this battery too. Yeah. So anyway, first person. You see here, we've got three unique tanks. All with different capacity. Which I never checked compared to vanilla hydrogen. I should have done that. Now, where did I put that tank? I believe it was here. Now, you can also see they all have the same... I'll take up the same amount of space, which is a 3x3x3. And the vanilla tank has a capacity of 5 million litres. Kind of handy. And this one, which has the lowest capacity of the three, has a capacity of 5 million litres. So this one is equal to that one. I just think this one looks better. Yeah, this one looks a lot better than vanilla. Then the one with the second highest capacity is this one. The Grotus. With a approximate capacity of 15 million litres. It just doesn't show it, unfortunately. This one is called Gladys. Okay. And this one has the highest capacity. Although it looks like it should have the lowest. I guess it just compresses it a lot more. I guess that's what these things on the sides are for. To compress it. Oh, this thing is actually equal on all sides. Interesting. Anywho. Excelius. With a capacity of 50 million. Take a look there. That's 25 million, that's 50%. So yeah, 50 million litres. That's gonna be an absolute boatload. Right, do these things actually have different weight values to them? Not sure. Yeah, 3.6 kilotons. Oh, 5 kilotons when full, I'm guessing. Okay, I might be reading it the whole thing wrong. Oh, that's the grid mass. This thing's 5 tons. This thing, also 5 tons. Oh, so 5 tons. Alrighty then. It appears you can fly through these sticking out bits. Interesting. Oh, your weight. 8 tons. They hold more and are lighter than vanilla. So that's actually a handy thing. Like, replace your regular vanilla one with that one. Same capacity, but it's lighter, thus less fuel is needed to lift. That's handy. The cost, though. Okay, about 280 steel plates. Did you do? You've got to be joking. It's cheaper to make this one. Huh. Wait a minute. All these are cheaper! Oh wait, apart from construction components and computers. Okay, not entirely cheaper. On small steel tubes. Not bad. A bunch of those would be handy. I might actually use this one on the Earth Eater. Anyway, here we have a battery. And the indicators, the connections between the different individual cells, I'm guessing. So anyway, it's got its input, well, output, input, storage, current, stored, and when it's fully depleted. Now the reason I'm not really going over that bit too much, because it's identical to vanilla, so this is more of a style choice. Although, wait a minute. Does it cost the same? I have a feeling it does. Yeah, they cost the same. So yeah, you just use them based on style. Isn't too bad. And now, time for this giant thing. As you can see by the vanilla one on top, that it's wider than two of these put together. What two of those put together? And its capacity is 63,000 liters. I can't really compare that to vanilla, because this has a capacity of 421,000 liters, which is a modification due to a different mod. Yes, the one that actually lets me put medium containers. Well, the one that came with this one. The double. Which has over 1 million liters. So yeah, I'm thinking that does have more than twice the amount of the vanilla capacity. Not 100% certain on that one. As for build cost, rampant. 60, 20, 8, 5, 35, 60, 50, 80, 600. Okay. It's cheaper. Wait. Surely it's. I need more displays and more motors. Let's steel tubes. These metal grids. Huh. Interesting. So yeah, that's all the blocks from that mod. I'm definitely using that one. I may not have much use for the others, apart from style. It does look pretty good. Yeah. Now, how about we move on to the handles? You see? Just a handle. Good luck at it. And bunk. Yep, you grab onto it. It's meant to be used for in zero-G environments. They say you're outside and you just grab it. And if you have another mod equipped, you can do something quite useful with it. And now if I latch onto there. Now this will normally be in space, and it's quite handy for this particular ship's design. I just can't access that. Open that. Can access its inventory. Okay, grab the weapon. Oh well. Never mind. That's why I gotta grab the weapon. Oh well. I got it. Oh no. Nah, it's not working. Uh-huh. Kinda sucks. Oh well, never mind. No wonder. No. So yeah, there's that. As for its build cost, it is 4 small steel tubes, 5 construction components, and 10 interior plates. I guess that's more to do with the internal, well, the storage thingy. It's 1,000 liters to it. Now he said he added that because he couldn't get rid of the actual storage part of it. Which is understandable, because it seems to be coded to be just like a passenger seat. And passenger seats all have 1,000. What do you do? Oh. gotta take that off. Yeah. Ignore that. So yeah. Not much else to say about it. Apart from the colouring and stuff. Which I never checked with these things. Bad habit of forgetting to check if something could be recalled or not. And the answer is yeah. That's handy. And not the entire thing gets recolored, but a decent area. It's pretty good. That has a bar that goes all the way across rather than... Is that like four different lights all merged together? Looks like if you take a closer look at it. Yeah. Looks like it's just four individual lights. Huh. Nice. So anyway, I'll have links for all, well, for both mods down in the description. And I hope you've all enjoyed this video. If you have, please leave a like and even subscribe for episodes. And I shall see you all next time. Bye.